Do you like Sizzler? You haven't had Sizzler since last few months due to lockdown. You think about making it at home but get overwhelmed because of the numerous things you need to make. Do you think making Sizzler is too much work? If answer to any one of the questions above is yes, then you are at the right place. Today I will quickly show you how you can make vegetable Sizzler at home. There is a restaurant in Pune, India named Yana Sizzler. It serves a number of Sizzlers. Here is the menu card. You can see that a Sizzler can be made in different varieties with multiple combinations. You need to choose the things in which you are good at making. More on it after a little bit. You can make a Sizzler at home even if you don't have a fancy Sizzler plate. You just need any flat base, wide mouth, skillet or tawa. I have used these pans for making Sizzler at home. There are three methods by which you can assemble and serve a Sizzler. First one is cold method, second is hot method, and third is hot method on fire. In cold method, you first assemble all ingredients in Sizzler plate and then heat the plate and sizzle it and then serve it. In hot method, you heat the plate first and then assemble everything and then serve the Sizzler. In hot method on fire, you keep the Sizzler plate on the fire and assemble the items while the Sizzler plate is already heating on the stove. Just remember, if you want more sizzling effect with less butter, then use the butter which is melted, and you can even add little bit of water to it for more steam. Also, instead of using a whole cabbage leaf at the base, use pieces of cabbage cut lengthwise with an inch of thickness like this. This way Sizzler doesn't burn. Here we go for assembling Sizzler by cold method. Take a Sizzler plate. Spread pieces of cabbage first on the plate. Then add the base noodles or rice in the center like this. Here I have used noodles as the base. On this base, depending on the size of your plate, place 2 or 4 cutlets. I use a bigger plate so that at least 4 people from my family can eat together. Then spread stir-fried veggies on this cutlet. The potato side need to be placed in both sides of the base. Pour sauce on the cutlet and veggies. Don't pour sauce on potato side. I haven't poured any sauce here because my kids don't like it very spicy. Now keep this plate on stove on medium to high flame. When the plate becomes very hot, you can take it on serving table and pour melted butter through sides. Or you may pour butter while the skillet is on the stove and your Sizzler is ready to eat. Now, as you know how to sizzle a Sizzler, we will see what goes inside a Sizzler. We need following things: a base, noodles or rice. Second, patties or cutlet. I am using veg patty here. Stir-fried vegetables, carrot, cucumber, zucchini, broccoli, etc. Fourth thing is a side of potato, like French fries, potato wedges, mashed potatoes, etc. Sauce, for example, ketchup, barbecue sauce, etc. And the sixth thing is, for assembling, you need cabbage, butter, water and coriander. So first thing is base. Decide what you want as a base, noodles or rice. While choosing, consider what is available at your home. If you choose noodles as base, decide what type of noodles you will make. While choosing, consider which type of noodles you are good at making. I make Hakka noodles well, so I choose this base while making Sizzler. If you are good at making pulao, then choose rice pulao as a base. Second thing which we need for a Sizzler is a patties or cutlet. Choose which one you are good at making. I have used aloo tikki, hara bhara kebab, corn patties, paneer chili dry in this section, and believe me, it turned out good. You just need to make sure the patties will taste good with the base you have chosen. For example, if I choose Hakka noodles as a base, then I choose paneer chili dry or manchurian in this section. Third is stir-fried vegetables. Use vegetables available at your home. You can cut veggies in a variety of ways, shown here like this. You can use carrot, cucumber, tomato, mushroom, green beans, onions, etc. Just make sure that you shallow fry them in butter or garlic butter and do not overcook them. Shallow fry all these veggies separately and keep aside. I also sprinkle chili flakes and black pepper powder on these veggies. Fourth item is a side dish of potato. You may use ready-to-cook frozen French fries or potato smileys or potato wedges or even mashed potatoes. I recommend you to use easy-to-cook side or prepare it day before. Fifth is sauce. I like barbecue sauce in my sizzler, so I use it generously whenever I make a sizzler. You can use ketchup or red chili sauce or can even use butter, garlic mixture as a sauce. See the variety of sauces we can use here. The last part is assembling all these ingredients to make a sizzler. For this we need cabbage, butter, water and optional coriander or spring onions. To cut the cabbage in desired shape, first take out a leaf from a cabbage, then fold it like this and then cut the cabbage like this. See one more time here. Take out a leaf, fold it like this and give the cuts. Now I will show you another method of assembling the sizzler, that is hot method on fire. I will put the sizzler plate on a stove on medium to high flame. Then I will spread the pieces of cabbage on the plate. Then I will add the base, which is rice here. On this base I will put cutlet. Then I will spread the stir-fried veggies on this cutlet. Then I will add potato side at the both sides of the base. Then I will pour sauce generously on the veggies. I will not pour sauce on the potato side. Now make sure the sizzler plate is very hot and then pour butter from the sides like this and your sizzler is ready to eat. See description of the video for detailed recipes.